Autism Spectrum Disorder, or ASD, affects about 1 in 36 children, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Despite its prevalence, little is known about the exact cause of ASD, and there is a lot of misinformation out there on the topic. One thing we do know is that genetics play an important role in determining whether a child is born with ASD. Over the past two decades, scientists at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory have been working to identify the genetic origins of ASD. Starting from the understanding that ASD affects more boys than girls, CSHL scientists have been able to develop a unified theory for the genetics of autism. Under this model, 99% of all families are at low risk of having a child with ASD. In low-risk families, ASD is the result of spontaneous, or de novo, genetic mutations, which occur more often on the father's genome. We'll return to the topic of the genome in a little bit. Boys born to low-risk families have about a 1 in 200 chance of having ASD, and girls' chances are about 1 in 800. According to the Unified Theory Model, about 1% of all families are at high risk of having a child with ASD. In high-risk families, ASD is not the result of a random genetic mutation. Instead, ASD is inherited. Children can inherit genetic variants that substantially increase their chances of being born with ASD. These variants are usually passed down from mother to son. Boys born to high-risk families have about a 1 in 2 chance of having ASD, and girls born to high-risk families have about a 1 in 8 chance. Scientists have also observed that almost every family that has more than one child with ASD was at high risk for ASD. So, these families are also at high risk of having additional children with ASD. Such families are called multiplex families. On the other hand, families that have only one child with ASD were at low risk for ASD, and therefore have a much smaller chance of having additional children with ASD. These families are called simplex families. Since 2007, CSHL and its partners around the world have invested tens of millions of dollars in autism research focused on simplex families. As a result, scientists have been able to identify hundreds of autism genes that, when damaged, increase a child's risk of being born with ASD. Recently, CSHL scientists have made another discovery. Siblings with ASD share more of their dad's genome than expected. To understand how this works, let's take a quick look at typical genome sharing. Children inherit 23 chromosomes from each of their parents, which are a combination of the genomes from their grandparents. On average, two siblings born to the same parents share 50% of their father's genome. Now, remember how we said ASD is sometimes the result of random genetic mutations passed down by the mother? Since moms are more likely to be carriers of these mutations, scientists expected that siblings with ASD would share more than 50% of their mother's genome, not their father's. But instead, scientists observed the opposite trend. Two siblings who are both diagnosed with autism tend to share more than 50% of their dad's genome. And when only one of two siblings has autism, they tend to share less than 50% of their father's genome. Why is this happening? Scientists aren't sure, but they have a few ideas. It could be that some dads carry autism genes as well as protective genes that prevent them from being born with ASD themselves. Or it could be that mom's immune system responds to dad's genes negatively during embryo development. There could also be other factors scientists haven't yet considered. The research on autism's genetic origins continues at Cold Spring Harbor and partnered laboratories across the globe. And as a result, scientists, doctors, therapists, educators, and families all around the world are reaching a better understanding of ASD. Together, our work can improve the health of expecting parents, as well as the lives of children and adults with ASD.